Hello and welcome to the preparation phase practical videos of the Security Incident Response course. In this video, we will review a tool part of the Sysinternals suite. This tool is called LogonSessions. The tool lists LogonSessions information. So if you're thinking that there is only one LogonSession, if there is only one logged in user, you're probably mistaken. So let's just take a look and have some more detailed view over the tool. First of all, I already have the Sysinternals suite downloaded and it's already in my downloads folder. I have unpacked it and I can access the tool from the actual folder. The tool is called LogonSessions and it's a command line tool. So to use and interact with the tool, I will need to start a command line window. So go to start menu, type CMD for command prompt, right click on it, and as usual, run it as administrator. Now when you have that window open, just type cd for change directory, copy and paste the path to the Sysinternals suite. If I type dir, I will have all the Sysinternals applications here listed. So the one we're looking for is LogonSessions. Minus h will give me actually some basic information and some help. So we can output the information from the LogonSessions to a CSV file or a comma, the comma separated. The other option will be, of course, CT, which will be a tab delimited file. Again, you can use CSV for that format and just, use Excel and tell it that it's not comma, but instead it's tab separated. You can stop the banner from showing up. This is the banner. And there are some other options. So for example, minus P, which is really useful, will show you all the processes that are started with that LogonSession. So the basic usage of these two will be just typing LogonSessions, hit it, and here are the results. We have 10 LogonSessions. Keep in mind that there is only my user logged in currently on this machine, but we have also the anti-authority anonymous login, we have the services, local services, we have other tools like that locked in. So if you want to have more information, you have the looking at the users, you have the SID of the user, which is useful, of course. There is the logon time. There is the logon server. If there was some additional network information, we would have it here. And of course, the authentication package, the logon type is interactive, meaning that I logged in directly on the machine. For example, it could be logon type 3, which would be a network logon, and that would be useful for you to know if it's a network actually connection. So additionally, we can use minus p to show the processes related to each logon, and this will pipe up a lot of information for each session. So if we start from the beginning, this is the initial starting session on the machine. There isn't a logon type, this is the actual system loading up, and these are the services and the processes that started with the load up of the system. We can skip to the user session here. Okay, that's my session here, and as we can see, there are some actually user specific processes running here. For example, Skype application, VBox tray, that's the virtual box, guest editions, and others. So if we have, for example, let's say I open Notepad, and if I tap that here, get the logon sessions, I will have Notepad here as well. So pretty much that's it about the logon sessions. I hope you find it useful, and I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.